Hello. So we're going to start in 2 minutes. Good evening. Right? It's 7:58. Empezamos en 2 minutos la clase. Let's get ready. Okay? Yes. ¿Estamos listos para la clase? Good evening. Hello, hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hi, are we ready for the class? ¿Estamos listos para la clase?
Yes.
Very good.
Yes.
Excellent, 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 excellent. Now. Let me show you my computer so we can start. Right. We start with the National English for Work program by beginner model. This is the week number 3 for this module. Right. And we're going to do today video conferencia número 11, information questions and answers. Okay. Information questions and answers. That's what we're going to do today. Right. Now, for this unit, unit 3, the question that we're going to do is, where do you work? That's the name of the unit. Where do you work? And the competencies that we have, number one, Claudia Yvette, can you tell me, can you please read number one? Describe the different.
Describe?
Yes, describe.
Describe the different departments in your workplace and what they do.
Okay, very good. Excellent. Describe the different departments in your workplace and what they do. Heriberto, number two, ask.
Okay,
ask questions about someone else duties at the workplace.
Very good. Number three, Ivan Ernesto. Ask for and say. Ivan?
Ask for and say time, the time of activity at our workplace.
At your workplace. Very good. Thank you. Number four, Carlos Roberto.
Tell different people the specific time and dates of activities I do in my workplace.
Very well. So we have, these are the four objectives or competencies that we need to accomplish. We're going to start with something from the last unit, so to see if we remember. This here, right? Look at my computer. Oh, what happened? One moment. Okay, this is what we need to do. Can you see my computer? Here we have.
Yes.
Okay, yes. Perfect. We have an exercise. We have Paul and Anne. They are husband and wife. So they are married, right? Husband and wife. They are father and mother. Together, they are parents. Together, they are parents. They have one son and one daughter. Together, they are children, right? The son's name is Jason. The daughter's name is Emily, right? He is her brother. She is his sister, okay? So we have husband, wife, father, mother, parents, son, daughter, children, brother, sister, okay? Now, look at this. Here we are using possessive what? ¿Cómo le llamamos a estos? Possessive adjectives or possessive nouns?
Nouns.
Possessive nouns. Very good, Joanna. Possessive nouns. We have an. Is Paul's wife. Anne is Paul's wife. Okay. Jason and Emily are there. Are there what? What do you think is going to be the answer? Estamos recordando los posesivos, los sustantivos posesivos, right? So, la mejor manera de hacerlo es a través de un árbol familiar. Okay. So we have Jason and Emily are there.
Children.
Are there children? Excellent job. Yes, of course. Are there children? Very good. Sorry. Are there children? Good, good, good. Paul is Anne's. What is Paul? Paul husband. Is Anne's
husband.
Husband. Yes, ma'am. Paul is Anne's husband. Excellent. Very good. So we have three answers right now. Number one, number two, number three. You are going to do number four. 5 until number 8, okay? Let's do it. Look at the map. Miren el family tree. Look at the family tree. Vean el árbol genealógico. And look for the answers, okay? Veamos si se acuerdan o si podemos trabajar con los posesivos. Let's do it. ¿Sí se entiende lo que estamos trabajando? ¿Lo que estamos practicando?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Very well.
Buenas noches, teacher.
Buenas noches.
Me acabo de incorporar y llegué tarde. No comprendo lo que están haciendo.
Ah, ok.
Por favor.
Yes, of course. Gracias. Okay. Now, we are working, it is first, with the family tree. Estamos utilizando el árbol genealógico, okay? We are using the family tree. We are practicing possessive nouns. Estamos practicando los possessive nouns. We're using the possessive nouns to complete the sentences with information. Husband, wife, father, mother, parents, son, daughter, children, brother, and sister. So, we are putting this together. Look at the example. It says, Ann is Paul's wife. Ann is Paul's wife, okay? Ann is Paul's wife, con possessive noun. Then we say, Jason and Emily are their children, okay? Jason y Emily son los hijos de ellos, right? De ellos dos. Paul is Ann's husband. Entonces estamos tratando de encontrar lógica al árbol genealógico usando o utilizando los posesivos, los possessive nouns, ¿okay? Los sustantivos posesivos. ¿Ok, Iris?
Veamos. Ok, gracias.
Tenemos. Ok, very good.
Gracias.
Finish. Very good, Joanna. Excellent. ¿Tienen preguntas? Let me know, please, if you have questions.
Finished.
Okay, excellent, Claudia.
Finished.
Very good, Iris. Thank you so much. What about the others? Are we about to finish? Nimia, Jessica, Carolina, Jenny, Ivan? Finished, okay, very good.
Finished, teacher.
Excellent. Nelson? Finished, okay, very good. Now, let's check the answers, okay? Let us check the answers. We have number four. Number four, it says, Jason is ants. What could be the answer, Joanna?
Jason is ants' children.
Okay. But remember, children is when they are together. Hijos, cuando tenemos son and daughter juntos.
Jason is Ann's son.
Ann's son, very good. Jason is Ann's son, very good. Number five, Claudia. Emily is Paul's.
No sé cómo se dice.
Daughter, repeat, daughter.
Daughter.
Very good, very good. Emily is Paul's daughter. Excellent. Number six over here, please tell me, Jessica. Jason is Emily's
brother.
What?
Brother.
Brother. Very good. Now, Nelson. Emily is Jason's
sister.
Sister. Excellent. And
what did I say?
Thank you. And let's see here. Carlos Roberto. Paul and Anne are Jason's.
Parents.
Parents. Excellent job. Good pronunciation. Parents. Very good. These are the answers. Okay. Do we understand the relationship? ¿Entendemos la relación entre cada uno de ellos?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Very good. Copy the answer.
Teacher.
Yes.
Perdón. Solo en la siete es sister.
Yeah.
Es que dice sister.
Yeah, it's sister.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Now, any other questions?
Mm-hmm. No.
No? No questions?
No. No.
¿Alguien más? ¿Alguna pregunta?
No, teacher.
No? Okay. Let's continue. Let's continue here. But first, vamos a poner resistencia antes que otra cosa.
Okay.
Let's see. Ana Daisy Fuentes Villegas. Brenda Iris Escamilla Pérez.
Present.
Carlos Roberto García Ramírez.
I'm here, teacher.
Carolina Yamilet Hernández Landaverde.
Present, teacher.
Claudia Ivette Samayoa Castro.
Present.
Denis Fernando Flamenco Nolasco. Emerson Adalberto Guevara Ortez. Heriberto Antonio Alas Mengíbar.
Present.
Iris Elizabeth Salazar de Flores.
Present.
Iván Ernesto Elías.
Present.
Jessica Rosemary Olmedo Fuentes.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Johaimo Alexis Ochoa Rivera. Julio Carlos Martínez. Karina Melissa Estrada Aldana. Milton Linares Molina. Nelson Iván Alfaro Flores.
Present.
Nimian Elizabeth León de Estrada.
Present.
Samuel Antonio Valencia. Samuel Antonio Valencia. Vilma Beatriz Reyes Márquez.
Present.
Jenny Carolina Martínez Alvarado.
Present.
Joana Beatriz Orellana Acevedo.
Present.
Very good. Thank you so much. Now we will continue here with the class. Now that we finished the possessives, right, we are going to do another activity here that is going to be from our book, okay? From our book. So I want you to please have your book ready porque lo vamos a utilizar para las actividades de hoy. Give me one moment. Okay, we are in unit 3. One second here. Okay, we're going to listen right now to the words that we have on page 29. Tenemos en la página 29 este ejercicio. On page 29. Now, I want you to look at right now, right here, the computer. Right? This is on page 29. Página 29, right? And we have, right, the pronunciation of this, right? These are departments in your company, right? Estos son los departamentos en los que se dividen la mayoría de empresas, no todos, pero la mayoría, okay? Now, with this, Karina, si no tiene audio, sálgase y vuelve a entrar, por favor. Sálgase y vuelve a entrar. Okay. Now, I am going to pronounce the words, okay? So, because they are a little bit different and difficult. So, listen to me, please, okay? Number one, production. Production. Number two, research and development. Research and development. Number three, purchasing, purchasing. Number four, marketing. Number five, human resources management. Number six, accounting and finance. Accounting and finance. Now let's see here, pronunciation, Heriberto, production. Repeat after me. Production.
Production.
Research and development.
Research and development.
Purchasing.
Purchasing.
Marketing.
Marketing.
Human resources management.
Human resources management.
Accounting and finance.
Accounting and finance.
Very well. Very well. Carolina, repeat with me. Production.
Production.
Research and development.
Research and development.
Research and development.
Research and development.
Purchasing.
Purchasing.
Marketing.
Marketing.
Human resources management.
Human resource management.
Human.
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 Not human. No, not human. Human.
Human.
Resources.
Resources.
Management.
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 Management. Perdón, management.
Manage.
Manage.
Ment.
Ment.
Management.
Management.
Accounting and finance.
Accounting and finance.
Very well. Thank you so much. And one more, I would like to listen to right now. I would like to listen to Nimia. Nimia, production.
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 Production, very bad. No es production, no, production.
Okay. Production.
Excellent. Research and development.
Research and development.
Research.
Search.
Research.
Feature.
Research.
Research.
Very good. Purchasing.
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 Marketing.
Marketing.
Human resources management.
Human resource management.
Human.
Human.
No.
Human.
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 Resources management.
Resources management.
Accounting and finance.
Accounting and finance.
Very well, very well. So what are we going to do right now? On page 29, what we can see here on page 29 is the following. We are going to go to page 29 on our book, right? This is page 29. And we see this vocabulary, right? What we are going to do with the vocabulary is that we are going to match the vocabulary with the possible definitions that they may have. For example, it says production. Research and identify what customers want. Mm-mm. Right? Let's see. Recruit, select, and train employees. No, I don't think that's correct. So you're going to keep looking for the answers. Okay, you are going to do this in groups. Remember, it's on page 29. Está en la página 29. Page 29. Vámonos a la página 29 todos, por favor. Page 29 right now. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Now we are going to do that in groups, okay? Vamos a hacerlo en equipos. So let's go ahead and work together. Te voy a poner en equipos. Escojan su grupo, por favor. Estén listos. Right. Let's start right now. Do you have any questions right now?
No questions.
No questions? No hay preguntas ahorita? No?
No.
Okay, so I will see you later then, guys. See you in a moment.
¿Qué necesitan los clientes? Algo así, ¿verdad?
Para mí ese sería marketing.
Igual para mí.
¿Alguna pregunta? Do you have any questions?
No question.
No questions. Okay, I see you in a moment.
Okay.
Como recepcionista, no.
¿Cuál?
Second. La segunda.
What is the pronunciation?
Research and development.
Research and development. No, es recepcionista. Son aquellos que están en las compañías y se encargan de mejorar los productos, hacer investigaciones, ver si yo vendo un tapete de coco.
Investigación.
Research es.
Pues yo creo que la opción sería develop, design new or improve existing products or process.
La página 29.
Ajá.
Teacher help.
Hello.
La encontró.
La pronunciación de la número 3.
Number 3. Purchasing.
Uh-huh.
Number
3. Purchasing. Ah, purchasing.
Purchasing, yeah?
Purchasing.
Purchasing. Así. Purchasing.
Yep.
Y, ah, y la palabra purchasing. Existing, así es. Existing.
La palabra
existing.
Where is that word? ¿Dónde está esa palabra?
Está en... ¿dónde está human research?
Manager. Existing.
A la, ajá, existing.
Existing.
Ajá. Ah, existing es.
Existing. Existing.
Ah, okay.
Existing. Okay. Gracias, teacher.
Gracias.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Anytime. Any other question?
Pues quiero ver, no, ahorita no. Estamos ahí resolviendo.
Okay.
Que yo les comentaba que yo ya las había estado haciendo durante el día para adelantarme un poco.
Okay, bien. That's good.
Y vaya, por, ay, ¿cómo se dice? Por
employers. Recruit, teacher.
Yes.
What is recruit? Recruit.
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 Recruit. It's, for example, imagine that Pollo Campero, they are going to open a new restaurant, right? Uh-huh. So they need to recruit new people so they can have employees in the new restaurant. Reclutamiento, recruit, reclutar.
Ok, recluta, selecciona. Ah, oh, pues la no, la número 2 es la 5. No, la 5 es la 2.
Ajá, la número 2 es el literal 5.
Ajá. Compra y.
Maneja el registro financiero de las transacciones que involucran la 3 sería la 6.
Sí, creo que sí, porque ahí habla sobre transacciones monetarias.
Ajá.
Vaya.
Reporte.
Control and supervision. 3 es la 6, ¿verdad?
Ajá, la 3 es la número 6.
Ajá.
La 4 sería la 1, porque es control y supervisión de la producción.
Work.
En este caso.
Workforce.
Dice que la parte del número 2 dice: es research and development. Dice que eso es investigación y desarrollo. Se pega más con el ítem 5. Con el número 5. ¿Verdad que sí? Con el número 5, donde dice develop this new or improvise existing product.
Con la número 3. La 6 es la 3.
Sí. Yo creo que la primera, esta sí es marketing, que sería el 4, y el ítem 5, que sería el número 2.
La número 4 es la primera, dice.
Eso digo yo, por ejemplo, de las
5. Sí, puede ser marketing. Uh-huh.
Va, entonces... Espérame que me estaban escribiendo en el chat.
Vaya. Production sería número. No. Número 4. Número 1.
Vaya, me faltan las últimas dos.
Rich and developed.
El último es for shame, for shame.
Ah, la número tres. ¿Y la antepenúltima?
Debo. Esta es la que estábamos diciendo que allí.
Acquire. Buy and acquire raw. Sí, seguro se dice así. Raw materials, production, equipment, etcétera. Etcétera. No sé cómo se pronuncia. Etcétera. Está compleja, ¿eh?
Sí.
For the use of the organization. Mm-hmm. Buy and acquire raw materials, production, equipment, etcétera, for the use of the organization.
Ya, ya le voy a poner ahorita. Escuchemos cómo llega hasta el etcétera.
Okay.
Ahí va.
Buy and acquire raw materials, production, equipment, etc.
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 Do you have any questions?
¿Cómo se pronuncia etc.?
Etc.
Etc.
In English, we don't say etc. anymore. We say and others.
Oh.
And others.
And others.
Yes. It is, I sent you a message. I need you to see it.
No lo entendí.
Que revise sus mensajes. I sent you a chat.
No.
Vea, vea.
Buy and acquire raw materials, production, equipment, and others. For the use of the organization.
Today.
Okay.
Develop, develop. It's not development.
Development.
Development. Ah, okay.
Development.
Employers. Okay.
Employees. Ivan, check out your chat.
Miss, ¿cómo se pronuncia recruit? La de la segunda acción, recruit.
Recruit, así, ¿cómo se pronuncia? Recruit.
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 Sería recruit. Select and training new employees.
Yes.
Employees for the right job, the company.
Exacto.
Ok. En la que tengo otra para pronunciar, develop.
Develop, sería, así se pronuncia.
Develop.
Yeah. That is correct, develop.
La tercera, no sé cómo pronunciarla.
Number three, purchasing.
Purchasing.
¿Cómo? Purchasing.
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 Purchasing. Purchasing.
Yes.
Purchasing. Okay.
Yes.
Purchasing. Purchasing.
Teacher,
yes.
Una consulta. ¿La tarea me quedó a medias o cómo? No, no logro entender.
Esa es la nota que tiene, 40. Yo revisé a las 4 de la tarde del sábado y esa era la nota que tenía, 40. ¿No los terminó o no los completó bien? Una no, de dos.
Es que creo que tuve un inconveniente. El día sábado me tocó trabajar todo el día y parte de la noche.
Sí, pero no informó.
Entonces, hice la tarea, creo que ya la hice el domingo, porque ya vine a la madrugada acá, el domingo, y ahí empecé a trabajarla.
Recuérdese que el viernes terminamos con esas tareas, el viernes.
Ajá, exacto.
Y el sábado yo reviso para ver si hicieron algún cambio, pero ya el domingo yo no puedo revisar el domingo.
Ajá, exacto.
Hizo entonces hizo el parcial y las tareas el domingo.
El domingo, aparentemente el domingo.
No, aparentemente lo hice o si después. Las hizo.
No, es que sí los hice. Okay. O sea, los hice en la madrugada. Ajá.
Ok. Entonces mañana vamos a revisar a ver cómo está.
Okay. Ah, ok, perfecto. Gracias.
Ok. Now let's go because I think everyone has finished. Let's go, finish. let's go. Yes. Okay, did we finish the exercise? ¿Terminamos el ejercicio? Yes, very good.
Yes.
Okay, excellent. I'm really glad that we did. So we can start right now, okay? Don't worry if we have different answers. Vamos a tratar de trabajar con cada uno. We have there, right? Page here, right? And tell me here, right? Production, number one. What is the answer for production? Tell me. What do you have with production?
Production.
Control and supervision the production.
Right? Control and supervise.
The production.
Okay, what is this?
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. La cuarta del lado derecho.
One, two, three, four. This one? Okay. Mm-hmm. Read the complete information, Brenda. Control.
Control and supervise the production, workforce, and inventory.
And inventory, right? Control and supervise the production, workforce, and inventory. Very good. Inventory. Repeat with me, Brenda. Inventory.
Inventory.
Okay. Inventory.
Inventory.
Excellent. Very good, Brenda. So, do you have a different answer? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta distinta? ¿La respuesta? ¿Todos tienen lo mismo? Control and supervise the production, workforce, and inventory. Okay. Vamos a ver. Number two. Who has number two?
Me.
Okay, Joanna.
Research and develop design new or improve existing products or process.
Okay. So it would be this one right here.
Yes.
Okay. Does everyone have the same? This is here. Develop, design new or improve existing products or processes. Read again, Joanna.
Develop, design new or improve exciting products or
processes.
Existing
products or processes.
Existing products or processes.
Very good. Thank you so much, Joanna. ¿Todos tienen la misma respuesta o alguien tiene algo distinto?
La misma.
La misma. Very good. Very good. Number three. Let's see who has number three. ¿Quién tiene número tres? Who has number three? Heriberto.
Number six.
Yes.
I acquire raw materials, production equipment, etc. for the use of the organization.
Very good. Okay, excellent. Now, equipment. Repeat, Heriberto.
Equipment.
Very good. Excellent job. Number four, marketing. Who has marketing? Marketing.
Number one of the right.
Go ahead, Heriberto. Number one, so there will be number four. Can you read the answer?
Research and identify what customer wants and need at the right place.
Very good. research and identify what customers want and need at the right place. That's marketing. Okay, marketing. Very good. Number five, human resources management. Yes, Carolina?
Is recruit, select, and train new employees for the right job in the company.
Very good, very good. Recruit, repeat, recruit.
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 No. Recruit.
Recruit.
Very good. Recruit, select, and train new employees for the right job in the company. Number six, who has number six over there?
Keep the financial records of transactions involving monetary inflows and outflows.
Very good. Keep the financial records of transactions involving monetary inflows and outflows. Excellent job. So these are the answers that you should have. Esas son las respuestas que todos deberían tener. Están muy bien. Very good job. Thank you so much. Very good. If you have something different, change it. Si tiene algo distinto, cámbialo porque esas son las respuestas correctas. Okay. Can we move to the next activity? ¿Podemos seguir a la siguiente actividad?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Very well then.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Now, I am going to show you today, right, one of the most important things that we need to learn in English. We have WH questions, okay? We have the WH questions. We have who, what, where, how, why, when. Okay, these are the WH questions. Okay, Brenda Iris, can you send me that message in private, please? Now, we have who, what, where, when, why, and how. These are the WH questions. Estas preguntas son conocidas como WH questions, okay? Porque la mayoría empiezan con WH, WH. That's why they are asked like that. And these WH questions, right, they tell us about information. When we use WH questions, we get information. Hasta ahora solamente hemos visto yes, no questions, right? Entonces solo hemos visto yes, no questions. Right now, we are going to practice WH. How are we going to practice WH? Okay, with WH questions, right? We have here, what? Vamos a ver acá. We are going to use what when we want to ask about things or situations, okay? When we want to ask about things or situations, we are going to use what, okay? If we want to ask about a place, ask about a place or location, you are going to use where. Okay? You are going to use where. Now, we are going to use how when we ask about manner. Cuando estamos hablando de la forma, okay, vamos a utilizar how. When we ask for a reason, we are going to use why. Let's see. We're going to use why. If we want to ask for time, for periods of time, for periodos de tiempo, right? Ask about periods of time. Okay. We are going to use when. We are going to use who. When we ask about or for people or a person. Okay. Those are the main uses of the WH question. Estos son los usos principales de las WH questions, okay? We have others here, for example. We use whose. Okay? Tenemos otra pregunta que se llama whose. Es whose. We use it for possession. Para hablar sobre posesiones. For possession. We use also which to ask about options. Estas son otras dos que podemos utilizar. We use what time to ask about the hour. Okay. Now, these are other examples. Estos son otros ejemplos que tenemos. Now, I'm going to put them right here, okay? Now, remember, what, we ask about things or situations. Where, ask about a place or location. How, ask about manner. Why, ask for a reason. When, ask about periods of time or the time. Who, ask about or for people or one person. Whose is for possessions, which is to ask about options, and what time is to ask about the hour. Tell me what are examples that we know. Well, ¿cuáles son ejemplos que tenemos de las information questions? Ahorita no la estamos utilizando, no la podemos utilizar en simple present, pero recordémonos, ¿dónde vamos a empezar estas preguntas? Tell me the examples that you know. ¿Cuáles son las
preguntas? What is your name?
What is your name, Joanna? Very good. What? What's your name? Very good. Where?
Where do you live?
Where do you live? Very good. Where do you live? How?
Where do you work?
Where do you work too? Okay, very good. And how?
What is manner?
What?
What is manner? What does mean manner?
Manner? It's for like situations, maneras. Give me a moment. Está lloviendo en mi casa. Solo me interesa. Ya no los escucho. Give me a moment. Okay. Right. It's like situations when we say, for example, right, how are you? Cuando estamos hablando de maneras, de situaciones, that's when we use, how are you? How old are you? Right? We use it, how are you doing? Right? These are manners, right? What would be why? ¿Alguna pregunta que hayan escuchado con why? Tell me. Any questions?
Why did you study?
Why do you study English? Very good. Why do you study English? Excellent. When? When? No?
When I was younger.
Okay, esa es una frase. Muy bien. When I was younger, cuando estaba más joven. ¿Y en pregunta?
When you go to the party.
What?
When you go to the party.
¿Cuál es mi cuenta del Banco Cucatlán?
No sé, Brenda, ¿cuál es su cuenta del Banco Cucatlán?
No sé.
Karina, very good. When do you go to the party? Very good. When do you go to the party? Excellent. Who? Who?
Who is he?
Who is he?
Who is he? Very good. Who is he? Excellent. Excellent. We have the same questions. Very good. Who is he? Then we have, for example, whose? We can say, whose cell phone is this? This is Sylvia's cell phone. Right? Whose cell phone is this? This is Sylvia's cell phone. And we use whose. Which, for example, with which, we can say, which color do you prefer? Yellow or green? Which color? I'm giving you options. Cuando usamos what, podemos decir, what color do you prefer? Pero abrimos las puertas para cualquier color. What color do you prefer? Right? Es general. Pero si decimos, which color do you prefer? Yellow or blue, right? I'm giving you options. It's more specific. Which cell phone do you prefer? Samsung or iPhone? Which is your favorite band? Right? Which is your favorite soccer team? So I'm giving you options. And what time? What time do you start the English class? For example, what time do you go to work? What time do you eat your dinner? Right. That's when we have this. So I need you to please copy or take a screenshot of this, please. Copien o tomen una captura de pantalla de esta. And then, Joanna, what's your question?
When do you use which?
When you give options. For example, I can tell you.
Siempre tengo que dar las opciones.
Most of the time, yes. 95% of the time, you need to give options. Right? For example, if I ask you, what is... what is your favorite kind of music? What is your favorite kind of music? What is your favorite kind of music?
Pero ahí es, se me tiene que dar las opciones o no?
Tell me, no, tell me the answer. What is your favorite kind of music?
All music and electronic music.
Okay, very good. All music and electronic music. Okay. Which is your favorite singer in electronic music?
Gareth Emery.
Okay, very good. Ahora, no usa opciones, pero ya estamos hablando de algo más específico. Okay? So, you're going to use which when we have something more specific and you have options. When I say, which is your favorite electronic music singer, you know that there are just a few.
Okay.
But if I say, what is your, or who is your favorite singer? Oof, you mentioned a lot, right? Very good. Now, any other questions about this? Hagan preguntas, por favor. Ya vamos a hacer varios ejercicios, que no se preocupen. But tell me if you have a question. Questions?
More example with using who?
Who? Who are you, for example? Who is your favorite? Who is your favorite person in the world? Who is your boss? Who do you eat breakfast with? Who do you eat breakfast with? Who do you live with? ¿Con quién vive? Who is your son or who is your daughter? We have many questions that we can make with who. Right? You can answer, who is your boss? My boss is Fulanito. Right? Who do you eat breakfast with? ¿Con quién desayuna? Oh, I eat breakfast with my husband, for example. And then we give the answers for each one of them. Nelson, what's your question?
Question.
Okay.
Sorry.
Now, we are going to work here. ¿Ya tomaron nota de esto?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, very well. we continue here with the next activity. In the next activity, right, we are going to practice right now, okay? This is only practice. We have here 10 different questions. We have 10 answers, okay? 10 questions, 10 answers. For example, if I say, what time is it? What do you think is going to be the best answer? ¿Cuál creen ustedes que es la mejor respuesta? What time is it?
It's 5 to 3.
It's 5 to 3. Excellent, Karina. Let me make this bigger. Okay. It's 5 to 3. Excellent job. What time is it? It's 5 to 3. Very good. Where is she?
She's at school.
What?
She is at school.
She is at school. Excellent. Very good. She is at school. So right now, we are matching the words in color with the possible answers. How many cats do you have?
I have 10 cats.
I have 10 cats. Very good. I have 10 cats. Now, do the other ones by yourself. Hagan las otras ustedes mismos. Mientras ustedes hacen las otras, yo paso asistencia. Okay? Let's do it.
Okay.
Easy, right? ¿Sí se entiende qué estamos haciendo, chicos?
Easy.
Yes. ¿Sí? Yes? Okay. Very well. So let's start. Let's continue. Let me see our Ana Daisy Fuentes Villegas.
Present.
Hi, Ana Daisy. Okay.
Hi, how are you?
Very good, actually. Thank you for asking. Now, we have Brenda Iris Escamilla Perez.
Present.
Carlos Roberto García.
Present.
Carolina Yamilet Hernández Renda Verde.
Present.
Claudia Ivette Samayoa Castro.
Present.
Denis Fernando Flamenco Nolasco. Emerson Adalberto Guevara Ortez.
Present.
Thank you. Heriberto, Heriberto Antonio Alas Mengíbar.
Present.
Iris Elizabeth Salazar de Flores.
Present.
Iván Ernesto Elías. Jessica Rosemary Olmedo Fuentes.
Present.
Julio Carlos Martínez. Karina Melissa Estrada.
Present.
Nelson Iván Flores.
Present.
Nimia Elizabeth León. Vilma Beatriz Reyes Márquez.
Present.
Jenny Carolina Martínez Alvarado.
Present.
Joana Beatriz Orellana Acevedo.
Present.
Thank you very much.
Teacher, present. Present. Nimia.
Okay. Nimia. Okay. Thank you, Nimia. Okay. So now we have this. Right. Did you finish? ¿Ya terminaron?
No.
Hi. Tell me when you finish or if you have a question. Dime si tiene alguna pregunta, por favor.
Complete.
Complete? Okay, good.
Yeah.
So Heriberto has finished. What about the others? Okay, you will finish right now. Only you, only Heriberto?
Yes, I'm finished.
Karina too, Joanna too. Who else? Quem más? Claudia, finish. Nelson, very good, excellent job.
Finish.
Okay, excellent, Carolina.
Finish.
Okay, let's check the answers, okay? Veamos la respuesta. Okay, let's see the answers that we have. We have number four. Number four, Nimia. What do you have in number four?
Is.
Okay, read the question.
I am.
Read the question and the answer. Read the question and read the answer.
Oh, okay. Okay. How old are you? I am 65 years old.
Yes, that is correct. How old are you? I am 35 years old. Very good. Number five, Mr. Heriberto.
Number five.
Yes.
Who is him? He's my father.
Very good. Who is him? He is my father. Very good. Number six. Help me with number six, Joanna.
How much does this cost? $35.
$35. Very good. $35. Excellent. Seven. Melissa.
Okay. Whose pencil is this?
Mm-hmm. Whose pencil is this?
It is Martin's pencil.
It is Martin's pencil. Very good. Number 8. Yvette.
Which drink do you want? I want water.
I want water, okay. Which drink do you want? I want water. Very good. When is the party? Number 9. Please do number 9, Nelson.
When is the party? It's the next Saturday.
It's next Saturday, yes. It's next Saturday. Very good. And the last one, right? Please read the last one, Jessica.
Why are you sad? Because I hurt and my head.
I hurt my head. Very well. Because I hurt my head. Excellent. After this, take your answers, please. These are the correct answers. Do you have any questions right now? ¿Alguna pregunta?
No question.
No questions. Okay. ¿Seguimos con otra actividad?
Ah, yes, yes. Heart is dolor.
No. It says, because I hurt my head, es cuando usted, por ejemplo, se golpea. Right? Se golpea. I hurt my head. Me lastimé.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm. Dolor is pain. I hurt my head. Now I feel pain. Pain. P-A-I-N. Pain. Another question? ¿Alguna otra pregunta? ¿No tienen preguntas?
No, no questions.
No questions. Okay. So let's do the next activity then. In the next activity, right, what we're going to do is the following. We're going to do information questions ahora con el simple present, okay? I want you to look at the information from your book, información de su libro, on page number 30, en la página 30, page 30. Page 30. We have information questions there. Ahí tenemos las preguntas, okay, que vamos a practicar. Information questions, página 30, right? Information questions and answers. Let's see here. First question, can you please read for me? Vamos a leerla y después le vamos a explicar la gramática. First one, Vilma, read the question and the answer.
What do you do? I work in the accounting department.
No, I supervise.
I supervise the product workforce.
Workforce. Repeat.
Workforce.
Workforce. Excellent. Workforce. Brenda, number 2. Brenda?
Hola.
Brenda Iris, read number 2, please.
Where do you work?
Okay, the answer, I work. I work. Brenda Iris, can you read the answer?
I work in the accounting department.
Very good. Thank you so much. Next one, Ana Daisy.
Is when do we go to meetings?
Recuérdense que esta información está en la página 30 de su módulo, okay? When do we go to meetings? Ana Daisy, the answer please.
We go to meetings two times a week.
Two times a week. Okay, very good. Joanna, read the next one. How do?
How do they plan the marketing? They investigate the customer needs.
They investigate the customer needs. Very good. Emerson? Emerson, are you here? Jessica, please read the last one. What time
do you take breakfast? I take breakfast at 8 a.m.
Very good. Thank you so much. Now, these are the examples that the book is giving us. Let's see the grammar part. Veamos la parte gramatical. I am going to show you here what we need to do. So we're gonna have WH questions, right? In simple present. So the formula that we are going to use for this, it's very simple, right? We're going to use here the WH word, plus do or does, according to the book, right? Plus do or does, plus the subject, right? Plus the verb, plus the complement. Okay? This is the formula. WH word, plus do and does, plus subject, plus verb, plus complement, plus question mark, right? So, based on this, what we're going to do is we are going to create one question. We are going to create a question right now with, tell me one of the WH words. Dígame una de las WH words.
What?
Okay, very good. What? That's one WH word. Tell me which auxiliary should I use? Do or does?
Does.
Does, okay. Very good. I'm using does. What is the subject that goes with does? In third person singular.
She,
very good. What does she, give me a verb? Deme un verbo, give me a verb.
Hit.
What?
Open.
Hit.
Open, okay. What does she open? Compliment.
The store.
What does she open? What does she open? What?
The door.
No, because that's what?
What?
What does she open? I need more information.
Supermarket.
What does she open in the supermarket? What does she open in the supermarket? What does she open in the supermarket? Digamos que es una set de las señoritas que anda poniendo todo en orden. What does she open in the supermarket? What could be the answer? Yo sentía a las señoritas que van a andar arreglando todo en los supers, en los supermercados, Walmart, Priceman, Super Select. What does she open in the supermarket?
Display.
What?
Display.
The displays. Okay. Display. Sí, así se llama. Sí se llama. But what does she open? Open es abrir. What does she open in the supermarket?
Jugger.
Okay. Okay, the doors. She opens the doors, okay? She opens the doors in the supermarket. Okay. Now, with the, this is the answer. Okay. This is the complete answer. But I want you to pay attention to this. When we say what, right? What does she open? And we want to know what, right? We say the doors. What does she open? She opens the doors. Esta es la información que nos importa. No importa quién, no importa el lugar, right? Importa el qué, porque la pregunta empieza con what. Okay, when we say, what does she open? She opens the doors, right? Si yo quiero preguntar por el lugar, ¿cuál sería la pregunta que tengo que hacer? Siempre con esta misma oración. Esta es nuestra respuesta. ¿Cuál sería la pregunta que debería hacer?
Where,
where, very good. Where se utiliza para lugar. Ok, estamos utilizando la fórmula. Ya tengo where. Very good. What should I put next? ¿Qué pongo después? Según la fórmula.
¿Pero
la fórmula? What?
El lugar, localización.
No.
No.
No, porque quiero saber eso. No puedo responder. No puedo utilizar en la pregunta la respuesta.
Ah, ya, ya.
Do or does.
Do or does. Very good. Y como la respuesta dice, she opens the doors in the supermarket, ¿cuál debo utilizar? Do or does?
Does.
Does. Where does?
She opens the doors.
Where does she open the doors? Very good. Where does she open the doors? Where does she open the doors? Meaning ahora. Ah, I want to know this. Where does she open the doors? In the supermarket. Right. This is what I want to know now. In the supermarket. This is what it's important to me right now. In the supermarket. Because this is the place. Y esto es lo que estoy preguntando. ¿Ok? Ahora tenemos la misma respuesta. She opens the doors in the supermarket. ¿Qué otra pregunta creen que podemos hacer? Miren la respuesta. What other question can we create?
Who.
What, who? Very good. Who. Ok, excellent. Vamos a ver acá. Who. Now, we are not going to use do and does, okay? Pero siempre en simple present. Who opens? Who opens what?
Who opens the door.
The doors in the supermarket. Who opens the doors in the supermarket? What is the answer?
She.
Very good, ma'am. Very good. She opens the doors in the supermarket. Very good. She opens the doors in the supermarket. Excellent job, right? So, if you see, right, what we're doing here is that we're looking for the questions, right, that will give us a complete answer. Una oración puede decirme a mí varias preguntas, okay? Me puede, una oración me da la oportunidad que yo haga varias preguntas, right? En esta oración hemos podido crear tres preguntas distintas. La fórmula que vamos a utilizar es WH más do and does, dependiendo del sujeto, el verbo y el complemento, y siempre nuestro signo de interrogación al final. ¿Okay? ¿Se entiende esta fórmula?
Yes.
Yes, Iris says yes. What about the others? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta?
Tengo una duda.
Yes, Joanna.
¿Por qué ahí le tuvo que agregar la S después de who?
Porque no utilizamos does. Porque en realidad esta se llama un subject question. Queremos saber el sujeto de la oración.
Cuando Entonces ahí ya está preguntando específicamente en una tercera persona.
Exacto.
Okay. Pero puede ser para primera persona, who open.
No, siempre es en tercera persona.
Ah.
Who closes the door? Who teaches the English class? Who works in the supermarket? So, siempre en tercera persona cuando estamos hablando del simple present.
Sin importar la cantidad de sujeto.
Sin importar porque no sabemos. Cuando preguntamos, no sabemos. Hasta que nos dicen, ya a saber. Who opens the door in the supermarket? Joanna and Karina open the doors in the supermarket. Two people, yeah.
Plus.
Okay, so are we good here? Thank you for your questions, Joanna. Gracias por sus preguntas. ¿Alguien más? ¿Nadie más? ¿Can I continue? ¿Seguimos? ¿Entendieron cómo se van a crear las preguntas? ¿Esta fórmula la entendieron?
Yes.
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 Yes, okay. Well, vamos a borrar esto. And we're going to do something else. Right? Now that we know the WH questions, ahora que ya la sabemos, right? We are going to do something here. Right? Oh my God, give me a second. Okay, we are going to use the questions from your book. Vamos a utilizar las preguntas que nos da su libro, okay? Las mismas preguntas de la página 30 las vamos a utilizar to create our questions, okay? Our information, right? We're going to show here. Let me see. Okay. Right now, in the written form, we are going to explain to a partner what activities you and a co-worker do in your department. Okay. We have these questions, right? What do I do? Where do you work? When do we go to meetings? How do they plan marketing? This is going to be about you, right? For example, I can ask you, what do you do? Right. Where do you work? When, in this case, is when do you go to meetings? When do you go to meetings? You and your coworker, okay? Usted y su compañero de trabajo. How do you plan the marketing? How do you plan the marketing? Si tienen marketing en su empresa, si no tienen marketing, podemos decir algo más. For example, Claudia Yvette, how do you plan the classes? Because she is a teacher, right? In case of Brenda, how do you make the financial reports? Right? What time do you take breakfast? We are going to give the answers, vamos a dar las respuestas a estas preguntas para expresar qué actividades hacen ustedes en su trabajo. ¿Ok? ¿Se entiende qué es lo que vamos a trabajar? ¿Se entiende qué es lo que vamos a trabajar?
Yes.
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 Yes. ¿Alguna pregunta? ¿Alguna pregunta? ¿No?
Co-worker es...
compañero de trabajo. Co-worker. My co-worker. Mi compañero de trabajo. For example, Carlos is Emerson's co-worker. Right? They work together. Now, utilizamos las preguntas entonces de la página 30 para responderlas, ¿ok? Con base en lo que ustedes hacen y un compañero de trabajo más. Pues, si ustedes trabajan solitos, puede ser alguien ficticio o las responden solamente acerca de ustedes, ¿ok? Let's start. Vamos a ver. Están en la página 30 de su libro, recuerden. Did you finish? ¿Terminaron? ¿Todavía no? Me avisan cuando terminen, por favor. Did you finish? ¿Terminaron?
Yes.
Joanna says yes. Heriberto, too. What about the others? ¿Qué de los demás? Thank you. Joanna.
Finished, teacher.
Finished? Okay, very good. Let's see the possible answers that we have, okay? Let's see. Right now, you are going to read only the answers. Ahorita ustedes van a leer solamente las respuestas, okay? Let's start with you, Joanna. Solamente lean las respuestas. Ya respondieron las preguntas, ahora leamos las respuestas. ¿Los demás? ¿Pongamos atención?
Yo, teacher, yo creé las preguntas.
No. Las preguntas ya están. Usted iba a responder las preguntas con su información.
Ah.
¿Qué hicieron los demás?
Hice, es que yo hice punto 5.
Punto 5. No, 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 no. Yo les mostré esto.
Ah. Bueno, well, no, no, ahorita la.
Ok. What about the others? ¿Ya terminaron? ¿Iván? ¿Jenny? ¿Vilma? Yes? Ok. Jenny, read your answers. Lea su respuesta, Jenny.
La única que quizás no se acopla a mi trabajo es la número 4.
Ok.
Pero, number 4.
Ok.
Number 1, I take control of students and teachers' teacher record. Number two, I work in the school.
Okay.
Number three, we go to meeting on a month.
Okay.
And number five, I take breakfast at 6 a.m.
At 6 a.m. Okay, very good, Jenny. Excellent job. You have done a really good job right now. Very good. Excellent. Vilma. What are your answers, Vilma?
I am the accountant. I work the accounting department.
Okay.
Wait to the meeting 5 days of the month.
Okay.
If they talking to customer, I breakfast at 6 a.m.
I have breakfast at 6. What? Six a.m.
6 a.m.
6 a.m. Very good. Okay. Very good. Very good. Now, we're going to see, very good, Vilma. Excellent job. Now, let's see who else finished. Jenny, Vilma, ¿quién más? Enciendan sus cámaras, por favor. Thank you. Recuérdense, el requisito de Insta for, no mío. Iván Ernesto. Yes, very good, Iván. Go ahead.
Okay. I revise to correct material.
Okay, I repair, okay.
Okay, I work in the finances department.
Okay.
We go to meeting on the times and weekend.
Okay.
I take break at 7 a.m.
Okay, perfect, perfect. Now, just work with this, financing.
Finance department.
Yes. Very good. Very good. Okay. Let's continue. Jessica Emerson, Ana Daisy, Karina. Por favor, enciendan sus cámaras.
Los leo y los míos. A ver si están bien.
Yes. Go ahead.
La 4 no se aplica a mi trabajo, no la hice. Okay. Pero la primera puse, I am a medical system.
Very good.
I work in Sunset Plaza building. We go to meetings tomorrow. Y I take breakfast at 12 noon.
At 12 at noon.
At noon. Ajá.
Okay, but breakfast es desayuno. A las 12 de desayuno.
Ah, pues y al mediodía, ¿qué es?
Lunch.
Ah, lunch. Ah, pues lunch. I take lunch at 12 noon.
At 12. Ajá, puede ser 12 at 12 p.m. Ahí se lo estoy poniendo en el chat. At 12 p.m. O puede ser at noon. Uno de los dos, no los dos.
Ajá.
At 12 p.m. Y cuando dice noon, es el mediodía.
Ajá, al mediodía.
At noon.
At noon.
I take lunch at noon. Very good, Carolina. Excellent job. Let's see, Emerson and Alberto. Camera open, please.
Lunch.
Good answers, Emerson.
No, 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 teacher.
Disculpe. Okay, pay attention, Emerson, so you can see, you can listen to the answers that your classmates are giving. Ponga atención, por favor, para tratar de responder. No importa si nos equivocamos, okay? Lo que importa es que tratemos. Veamos, Carlos Roberto. And then, Ana Daisy. Carlos Roberto. Read your answers.
A ver, teacher. Todavía no las termino, pero le voy a decir las que ya tengo.
Ok, please.
Yo igual, al igual que Johanna, creé mis propias preguntas al principio, pero entiendo que hay que seguir, ¿verdad?, el ejemplo y responder respecto a eso. Entonces, puse, I analyze our client's credits.
Ok, very good.
I work in the back office department.
I work?
In the back office department.
In the back office department. Okay, very good.
We go to meet meetings. Y ahí iba a poner este, what time at month, ¿puedo decir?
We go to meetings.
What time? One time at month.
Once a month. Okay, very good. Mm-hmm. Once a month. Una vez. Dice once. Once a month. Una vez al mes. Once a week. Una vez a la semana. Okay. Once a day, una vez al día. Okay?
Once a month.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Once es una vez. Ana Daisy, what are yours?
Okay. I usually am concurrent in a minute. I work in the office. Mm-hmm. I work in the office. Emerson. Carlos Alberto and Dennis start working at 8.
At 8, yeah. Oh, okay, very good. What else?
We prepare reports, call, hacer llamadas,
make calls,
We have to talk about processes, information,
okay,
de informática,
technology processes. Okay, very good. Thank you so much, Ana Daisy. Very good. Trate, como consejo, para todos. Trate de hacer oraciones cortas. Subject, verb, complement. ¿Ok? Para que no se confunda. Sujeto, verbo, complemento. Somos beginners. Recuerden, estamos comenzando. Sujeto, verbo, complemento. ¿Ok? Now.
Thank you.
You're welcome. We're going to try to do this exercise. It says, vamos a hacer lo mismo que hicimos en la explicación. Ya tenemos la respuesta, right? We have the answers. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 answers. So we need to create 5 questions. The first one says, I have to write a report about the production every Friday. Okay? So, what would be the question for number one?
What do you do Friday?
Excellent job. That's an excellent job. Very good, Emerson. What do you do every Friday? Very good. That is going to be the question. It's a una. Okay. What do you do every Friday? Recuérdense. Right? Acá está un signo de interrogación, así que ya no sé, se lo pongo. What do you do every Friday? Well, I have to write a report about the production every Friday. Okay. Now, what would you do in number two? What would you do in number 3, 4, and 5? Let's think about the questions. Tienen 5 minutos para ver las posibles respuestas. Este ejercicio también está en su libro, en la misma página, ¿ok? Lo tenemos en la misma página, abajo de la tablita, página 30. Ejercicio 5. Ese creo que ya lo tiene, Joana.
Yes. Este
ya lo tiene. Ok. Let's wait, ¿ok? We have to wait.
Teacher, pero ¿y si yo lo tengo diferente a Emerson?
Es posible. Es posible siempre y cuando haga conexión con la respuesta.
Okay.
Okay. Ya lo vamos a ver. Sí, lo pueden tener diferente. ¿Cuántas preguntas sacamos del ejemplo que está en la explicación de, la, de las preguntas? She opens the doors in the supermarket. ¿Cuántas preguntas sacamos?
Three.
Tres preguntas, exactamente. Lo cual significa que pueden haber diferentes respuestas. Hay posibilidades, ¿ok? Siempre y cuando concuerden con la respuesta. Las respuestas son bien específicas. Okay. I have to write a report about the production every Friday. ¿Qué le tendría que agregar usted en su pregunta? Carolina, ¿qué le agregaría usted si ya tiene esa respuesta?
Every Friday.
What do you have to do at work every Friday? Exactly. Very good. What do you? What do you have to do at work every Friday? Tell me, did you finish? ¿Ya terminaron? Sí. Finished. Very good, Carolina. Excellent job. Let's see a couple of answers. Veamos una, un par de respuestas, ya que son las 9:56. Okay? Let's see a couple of answers. What would you, can you please, Joanna, and then Carolina, read your possible questions for number one. Vean las otras posibilidades. Joanna?
When do you have to write a report about the production?
When do you have to write a report about the production? I have to write a report about the production every Friday. That is correct. Thank you so much. That is correct. Carolina, read your complete question.
What do you have to do at work every Friday?
What do you have to do at work every Friday?
Every Friday. Repeat. What do you have to do at work every Friday?
Okay, I have to write a report about the production every Friday. Very good. Who has something for number two? Veamos la número dos. Number two, Jenny?
Where do you work?
Where do you work? I work in the blue building. Okay, very good. What's another question that you can create?
What time?
Ah?
La tres?
No, number two.
Ah, la número two.
¿Pudieron crear otra, otra pregunta para el número dos? Besides, where do you work?
Where do you work? Tengo yo.
Aparte de where do you work, ¿pudieron crear otra pregunta? ¿Alguien más?
What color is the building? Where do you work?
Where you work, exactly.
Where you work.
What color is the building where you work? Exactly. I work in the blue building. That's another option. Very good. Very good. Now, we're going to write the options tomorrow. Vamos a escribir las respuestas mañana. Si no las terminaron, hay que terminarlas, por favor. Mm-hmm. And let me call the attendance. Vamos a pasar la asistencia. I have Ana Daisy Fuentes.
Present.
Brenda Iris Escamilla. Carlos Roberto.
Present.
Carolina Yamilet.
Present.
Claudia Ivette. Dennis Fernando. Emerson Adalberto.
Present.
Heriberto Antonio.
Present.
Iris Elizabeth.
Present.
Iván Ernesto. Jessica Ross. Jessica Rosemary.
Present.
Julio Carlos Martínez. Karina Melissa. Nelson Iván.
Present.
Nimian Elizabeth. Vilma present. Beatriz.
Present.
Jenny Carolina.
Present.
And Joanna Beatriz Orellana.
Present.
Very good. So we have finished here with the class today. Today is day number 11, so I'm supposed to stay with Jessica Rosemary Olmedo. Okay. We have rest. Have a beautiful night. I see you tomorrow at 8 p.m.
Bye-bye.
Tomorrow.
Bye-bye. Bye.
See you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
See you tomorrow.
Good night.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, teacher.
See you tomorrow.
I'm present, pero tuve problemas con el in.
Okay, Karina, I understand. Okay. Jessica. Hi, Jessica. Do you have any questions about the class?
No.
¿No tiene
preguntas? Lo que me está costando, quizás, crear otras preguntas aparte de las que ya tenemos.
De las usuales.
Uh-huh. Ah.
Sí, pero acuérdense que eso va a venir con la práctica. Entre más practiquemos, más cómoda se va a sentir. Pero pudo crear las preguntas de ese ejercicio.
Sí, de la única que quizás dudé fue de la 4 que decía We the Saints and the other create the new product. Y yo la pregunta que puse es when do we activities? Entonces, no sé.
¿Qué puse ahí? What do we activities?
Uh-huh.
Ok. Podemos, veamos la pregunta acá. ¿Qué hacen? Podemos hacer esta pregunta, mire. Jessica, we can ask a question. Look at the chat. Okay. What do you and your coworkers do? What do you and your coworkers do? ¿Por qué? Porque la respuesta pues me da acá la opción que yo diga. We design and others create a new product. Okay. O, ajá, entonces, what do you and your coworkers do? Oh, we design and others create a new product. Ahí le estoy diciendo qué actividades hacemos nosotros en la compañía.
Okay.
What do you and your coworkers do? Okay. ¿Cuáles son las otras que tienen?
De ahí la 5 que es when do you take go to the meeting?
What?
When do they go to the meeting?
When do they go to the meeting? Okay. Pero en la respuesta, ahí no me dicen cuándo.
No.
No, ¿verdad?
No.
No me dicen cuándo. ¿Qué me están diciendo ahí en esa pregunta, en esa respuesta?
A veces.
¿Ah?
Dice, they have a meeting because we have to talk about in the inflows and outflows.
Ok, muy bien, muy bien. Entonces, en este caso, si dice because, ¿cuál sería? Dice, they have a meeting because we have to talk about the inflows and the outflows. Okay. So, si dice because, siempre que usted ve la palabra because, es razón, is a reason. Es una razón. Entonces, usted tiene que utilizar why. Siempre que ve, sí. Siempre que usted vea en la respuesta because, es porque la pregunta es why.
Okay. Sí, entonces, why do they go to the meeting?
Why do they go to the meeting? Exactly. Why do they go to the meeting? Very good. They have to go to the meeting.
Meaning because.
Y ahí tiene la respuesta, ¿ok?
Yes. De la que si no hice pregunta fue de la 3, donde dice Mary and I start working at 10 p.m.
Ok, Mary, ok, very good. En ese caso, teníamos una de las preguntas que copiamos que hablaba de la hora. ¿Cuál era?
What time.
What time, exacto. What time, en ese caso sería, what time do they start working?
Okay.
What time do they? ¿Quiénes son they?
Ellos. Bueno, nosotros.
Ah, pero en este, no, en este caso es de María and I. Pero what time do we? Nosotros, we. What time do we?
We start in the world. Sí.
What time? Yes. What time do we? No, es, no, si es, le digo, en este caso, como nos están preguntando a nosotras, digamos que alguien nos pregunta a usted y a mí, usted es Jessica y yo soy María, okay? Jessica and I start working at 10 p.m., okay? Entonces, pero alguien más me está preguntando a mí. Si alguien más me pregunta, se va a estar dirigiendo a nosotros, ¿verdad?
Sería we.
Sería you.
Ay.
You, what time do you start working? Ah, nosotras, we start working at 10 p.m. El we sería si nosotras lo queremos cambiar. En vez de decir María and I, podemos decir we.
Solo en esas tenía.
Solo en esas, ¿ok? Yeah. ¿Alguna duda de alguna otra actividad? En la plataforma usted va súper bien, así que ahí no me... No me para nada. ¿Alguna otra okay. pregunta? ¿Algo más?
No, teacher. ¿No? Solamente.
Solamente. Ok, no. Jessica. Cualquier pregunta, ahí estamos en el chat para estar trabajando con usted. Y si tiene preguntas en la clase, también hágalas, ¿ok?
Perfecto. Okay, thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Have a beautiful night. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.